EPA's Superfund program protects citizens from the dangers posed by abandoned or uncontrolled hazardous waste sites. In the past, getting these sites cleaned up often required a significant outlay of energy and non-sustainable resources. The traditional approach for contaminated soil has been to excavate the material and haul it away. Unfortunately, this operation has a domino effect by disturbing uncontaminated areas, including the clean soil needed to backfill the excavation. Now, EPA has introduced a green remediation initiative that considers the environmental effects of the remedial strategy early in the process and incorporates options to maximize the net environmental benefit of the cleanup. From the selection and design of the remediation technology to the management of on-site activities to the use of energy conservation and alternative sources of clean energy, green remediation helps save natural resources and taxpayer dollars. Outside the small Virginia town of Crozet, EPA is doing just that by using phytoremediation to remove hazardous contamination from a residential property. Phytoremediation uses specially selected plants to remove or reduce the risk of contaminants in the soil, water, sediments, and air. The 2-acre site, a former orchard, is contaminated with arsenic, which is a byproduct of pesticide application on fruit trees.
Prior to 1972, there was legal application of pesticides, lead arsenates, DDT, DDE, and DDD. EPA banned them in 1972, however, there's a lot of orchards that still had the product on the soils. And since then, a lot of these orchards have since been sold off and developed into residential properties. Arsenic doesn't break down like DDT, DDE, and DDD does, so that's a little more pervasive. It's not very mobile, so it actually stays in place where it is, and that's actually helping us. And essentially the top roughly 0 to 6 inches are contaminated.
The contaminated areas of the hillside are used by adults, children, and pets on a daily basis. Because arsenic is a known carcinogen, mutagen, and is detrimental to the immune system, the soil needed to be cleaned up. Phytoremediation was chosen because, if conditions are favorable, the technology can be effective while having minimal impact on existing topography and the ecosystem. Phytoremediation is also considered an in situ or in place remediation approach, which means the contaminated media isn't transported off-site. And since plant cultivation and harvesting are relatively inexpensive processes, phytoremediation has significant cost-saving advantages compared to traditional cleanup methods.
Superfund's been around 25 years. We've learned a lot about, if you dig and haul, it's a very energy-intensive operation. You have a huge equipment that takes a lot of money to operate. Instead of bringing in a lot of heavy equipment, being very disruptive, knocking down all those trees, hauling off all this dirt and putting it someplace else, and then trying to find some clean soil to bring back in here, they're trying to do an in-situ extraction using these ferns.
The ferns were developed at the University of Florida and licensed to Endenspace, a leader in the use of plants for environmental protection and renewable fuels.
We've done a lot of work looking at different plants and their ability to accumulate arsenic. And we found that really only ferns in this genus, this particular genus, terrace ferns, accumulate arsenic. And they take up arsenic to a very high concentration. They tolerate high arsenic concentrations in their leaves. And they do a remarkable job of extracting it from the soil.
In fact, the hyper-accumulating Victory variety of Terrace vitata sold by Endenspace under the label Eden Fern holds concentrations greater than 200 times more than other plants tested for arsenic phytoremediation, and is adaptable to conditions in a variety of climates. USEPA's relationship with the property owner also helped in choosing phytoremediation.
I feel a real close connection to the property, and I want it to be at the property. Sort of like if you have a patient in the hospital, you want to be there with that person. I consider this land my responsibility. And I have been able to work with the EPA members. They're really friendly and they don't mind my so-called interference.
Getting the job done is relatively simple. Areas of the hillside with elevated levels of arsenic were mapped into 30 by 30 foot plots, then tilled to a depth of approximately 4 inches.
Well, really, the goal here is to be able to optimize plant growth, because if we get the plant roots to develop well and get the plants to grow well, they will take out more arsenic from the soil. So we want to do everything we can to prepare the site and to try to get optimize the plant growth.
We did soil composition testing to see what sort of nutrients we need to apply. In this case, we did a very mild nitrogen-based fertilizer, slow-release formula, put a little lime in to neutralize some of the soil. Once we do that, we lay down landscape fabric, cut holes in it in a 1 square foot area, and in this particular case, you're doing 30 by 30 grids.
Then we transplant the ferns in, and from then on out, it's a matter of keeping them wet until the roots get established in the soil and providing the shade that they need. In an environment like this, that's easy because of the trees.
In the few areas where direct sunlight could reach the ferns, 60% shade cloth was placed over the plots to improve plant growth. For irrigation, the plots were divided into 2 systems. The first system utilizes a spring at the top of the hill close to the residence that gravity feeds into a storage tank, which in turn, gravity feeds the fern plots. The other half utilizes a solar-powered pump. A low-pressure drip-tape irrigation system delivers fresh water to the ferns during dry spells. During periods of adequate rainfall, water from the spring is diverted and recovered into the storage tanks for later use. The ferns will be grown for approximately 5 months, or until night temperatures drop below freezing and plant growth and biomass production ceases. The fern biomass will be harvested and then sampled for arsenic content. Because arsenic levels in the harvested plants are expected to be below prescribed levels, they can be disposed of in a municipal landfill. Soil sampling will be conducted at the end of the growing season and compared to pre-planting samples to determine the fern's effectiveness.
In some areas, the arsenic concentrations are higher and it will take more than one season, we anticipate. But for a large part of this site, we think we can do it in a large part of it in 1 year.
Phytoremediation is ideal for targeting small areas like the 30 by 30 foot plots at the Crozet site. The technology does have limitations though. At some sites, contamination may just be too deep for plant roots to reach. But under the right conditions, phytoremediation is a win-win for cleanup teams and the public.
People generally like the idea of being able to use a plant to take contamination out of the soil. That's something that has a lot of public appeal, and I get a lot of positive feedback for it.
And then nothing succeeds like success. So this site is important, I think, because it represents what we're seeing more of across the country in other states, especially on the West Coast. Old orchards that are being built upon, people retiring on them, or they're just building homes, and it's part of urban sprawl. With this technology, it's very low tech. It's very, like I said, low impact, and you're not using a lot of energy. And what we're using here are sustainable or clean energy forms. We're using solar panels to drive our pumps for the drip irrigation system, and we're using a minimal amount of energy.
So the goal here is not to be green, but it's a really good secondary thing. Our goal is to protect public health and the environment. This happens to be an alternative technology that will do that with less waste and a greener atmosphere. It actually goes along with the EPA initiative of going green, and it also achieves our task within the removal program